Hello, friends. In this review, we will examine a Zigbee sensor from the popular and well-known manufacturer Sonoff, model SNZB-05P. The device has several features that distinguish it from other similar sensors. One of them is its design, which allows it to be used not only for detecting water on the floor, when the signal contacts are directed downward, as with most analogs, but also for detecting falling droplets when the contacts are directed upward. The water detection area can be expanded using the special WLDC200 cable and, if necessary, even multiple cables. More details on this will follow, but for now, as always, I ask you to like this video. This will help others interested in smart home technology find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Type of device, water leak detector. Model, Sonoff SNZB-05P. Additional, water-sensitive cable, WLDC200. Interface, Zigbee 3.0. Protection class, IP67. Battery type, CR2477. Declared lifespan, 5 years. Sensor dimensions, 48x48x21.6mm. Additional cable length, 2 meters. I purchased a ready-made kit, sensor, and cable, but you can order everything separately, as some people may not need the cable, while others may require multiple cables. One of the side panels lists the device specifications, which I have already mentioned. The packaging is designed in the familiar orange color typical for Sonoff Zigbee devices. Inside, I found the leak sensor and a package containing the water-sensitive WLDC200 cable. Everything together. I want to clarify that when using the cable, the sensor contacts will be covered. I will explain this in more detail later. Also included in the kit are 3 plastic cable holders, which can be attached using double-sided tape or screws. There were no screws in the box, but holes for them are provided. There is also an instruction manual, a small booklet in several languages. I didn't need it, the sensor is simple, and it's unlikely that anyone would make a mistake using it. The sensor has a square shape, 48x48mm, with a thickness of 21.6mm. On one side, there is a cup-shaped recess containing 2 signal contacts. The edges of the housing are raised almost flush with the contacts. In this position, the sensor will react to water droplets falling from above. If you turn it over, it will touch the floor with the corners of its sides, and water can seep inside from all 4 sides, short-circuiting the internal contacts. This way, it will react to puddles. The side opposite the signal contacts is removable. It serves as the battery compartment cover. To remove it, it must be unscrewed. Inside, there is a reset button. I marked it with a blue arrow, and the battery compartment, which currently contains a protective tab preventing the battery from discharging. Like other sensors in this series, this one uses a CR2477 battery, a thick button cell. According to the manufacturer, it should last for 5 years. A blinking LED indicates that the sensor is in pairing mode. To activate it, hold down the reset button. The WLDC200 cable is designed to extend the area that the sensor will respond to in case of water leakage. It is made with a water-permeable braid, and when water gets on it, the wires inside the cable short-circuit. On one side of the cable, there is an attachment that is placed on the sensor's contacts and secured there. It features a USB-C port, which allows another identical cable to be connected via the USB-C connector on the opposite end. I thought it would be a good idea to cover these connectors. After all, the sensor itself is rated IP67, so I additionally installed silicone plugs. Links to them will be in the video description. Once again, I want to clarify that when the cable is installed, the sensor's signal contacts are covered by the attachment, meaning only the cable itself will respond to water. Its length is 2 meters. Let's move on to checking compatibility with smart home management systems. We'll start with the native system, Ewelink. I use the NS Panel Pro as my Zigbee gateway. If you're interested, you can find a link to the review in the video description. The current firmware version at the time of testing is 3.7.2. This device has many interesting functions, which are covered in detail in the review. However, we are only interested in one, the Zigbee gateway. We enable pairing mode, and on the sensor, the LED should start blinking. The sensor is detected and added to the system. Its status is displayed both in the general list and in the list of devices connected to the gateway. By clicking on its row, we enter the sensor's plugin. Let's test its operation. The sensor is triggered when the signal contacts are shorted, whether by water or a metal object. When the contacts open, the status resets. The same applies when using the signal cable. If it gets wet, the sensor will trigger. The leak status will remain active until the cable dries or is disconnected. Drying can take quite a long time. This is how the sensor statuses look in its plugin. Additionally, the top of the screen displays the current battery level. There is also a log of sensor activations. In the general information menu, you can check the firmware version. Current at the time of testing is 1.0.2. View the battery type and charge level, and remove the device from the system. In automations, the sensor can only be used in the triggers section, if, which is logical, as the sensor is a signaling device and cannot perform any actions on its own. As a trigger, you can use three status options that the sensor can be in: no leak, leak detected, and offline in case of connection loss. Practice shows that many Ewelink Zigbee devices can be used in the Tuya Smart ecosystem. If not fully, then at least partially. For testing, I am using a wired version of the gateway from this ecosystem with support for Apple HomeKit. The review device was correctly recognized as a leak sensor and added to the system. The image displays a version with an external wired sensor. You can also find a review of one of these sensors in the video description. The sensor works, reacts instantly to contact closure, and the status in the plugin changes. However, some nuances were discovered during testing. For example, the battery level is incorrectly detected and is displayed as fully discharged. In automations, it can also only be used in the triggers section. Two sections are available here, which, for some reason, appeared in Chinese: sensor status and flood status. Each has two states, on and off. Nothing particularly interesting was found in the general settings section. However, another nuance appeared. The sensor rather quickly transitions to offline status. At the same time, if it detects a leak and triggers, it will return online and change to the triggered status. Through the native Tuya integration and Home Assistant, the sensor appears in the system. However, it also transitions to an unavailable state simultaneously with the application, which is logical. This is how it looks in the event log. The sensor was unavailable, then I press the button on the back. A short press updates the status, and it changed to no leak, then back to unavailable and again no leak detected. Another integration through which this gateway is connected is HomeKit, which works similarly to Apple's original application. In terms of device connectivity, the sensor appeared here as well. Two entities were found here: a sensor for the device's status and an identification button, pressing which does nothing. Triggering occurs correctly and quickly. Let me remind you that the HomeKit protocol works locally, without cloud services. I did not notice any transitions to an unavailable status. In Google Home, the sensor did not appear with either this gateway or the NS Panel Pro. Next, I will check how it works with another Sonoff device, the local smart home management center, iHost. Unlike the NS Panel Pro, it operates locally and has its own control system. The firmware version current at the time of testing is 2.4.2. The sensor was connected normally. Everything was detected completely correctly, which is not surprising since this is the same manufacturer. On the device tile, in the general list, its current status and battery level are displayed. The letter E in the upper right corner indicates that this is an end device. This is how the sensor tile looks when a leak is detected. If you go to its page, the same information is displayed: the sensor status and battery level. This is what it looks like when triggered: a leak is detected. The reaction is almost instantaneous. Let me remind you that iHost operates locally, without needing access to cloud services. The event log will display status change events, including date and time. Device information. No additional settings for the sensor are provided. Let me remind you that, like the vast majority of Zigbee devices powered by batteries, this sensor is an end device. It can only be used in automations within the triggers section, as an event generator, upon which one or more actions are executed. Two event options are available: switching to the leak detected state and the no leak state. The next thing I will check is the standard integration for Zigbee devices in Home Assistant ZHA. For this, I use a USB coordinator with SkyConnect firmware. I start pairing mode for new devices and hold the button on the sensor until the LED starts blinking. It is detected and added to the system. Besides the binary sensor that displays the leak detection status, there is also an entity that should check the firmware version, battery level, and identification button. Immediately after connection, their status may be displayed as unknown. This is normal. After a while, it will update. Everything works correctly and almost instantly. This is what water detection looks like. Zigbee information. As I mentioned earlier, the sensor is an end device. Most of the time, it remains in sleep mode, conserving battery life. The last system we will test in this review is Zigbee 2 MQTT, with the latest version at the time of filming being 2.1.0. As the manufacturer claims, the sensor is officially supported without needing external converters. Everything is displayed correctly: model, sensor type, image, battery level, and firmware version. At first, all entities are in the none status. This is normal. If the contacts are shorted, the leak sensor status is immediately updated, as well as the low battery binary sensor. It does not show the level but instead indicates when the battery needs replacing. This is the normal status, clean, no leaks. After a while, the battery level also updates. Since updating Zigbee 2 MQTT to version 2 and above brought many significant changes, I should note that I have the action sensor mode enabled. This is more convenient for me. However, in this case, it does not affect anything. Through the MQTT integration, two binary sensors are transmitted, leak detection and low battery, along with a standard sensor showing the actual battery level. Everything works correctly. Functionally, this is an ordinary leak sensor. Some of my reviews on similar devices can be found via links in the description. However, in terms of design, it has interesting differences, such as the ability to detect falling droplets and the option to extend coverage with a water-sensitive cable. If using the cable, I recommend sealing the USB-C ports with plugs. The sensor is supported in Ewelink and Tuya Smart, though Tuya has an issue with transitioning to offline status, even though the sensor continues to detect leaks. It works fully with Sonoff iHost and in Home Assistant through ZHA and Zigbee 2 MQTT. That's all for now. I hope this video was helpful and interesting. I'd appreciate your likes. They help with YouTube promotion. If you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, I will leave links to stores where you can purchase this sensor, my Telegram channels and social networks, as well as discussion groups for smart home topics. Join in. It will be interesting. Thank you for your attention and see you next time. Peace to all.